Health Science Academy here at Wekiva High School was started to increase our numbers in career and technical ed, and the administrative team felt that they wanted to offer a curriculum that can meet the needs of our students. And we know that healthcare is growing. Students can get a job at entry level with certification all the way up to PhDs.
I always had like a passion for the medical field. I always wanted to become a doctor when I was young, so I heard about this during school the year before, so it definitely jumped out at me and I decided to go into it.
I wanted to be a general surgeon, so I thought this course would help me a lot when I go off to college.
I helped my mom taking care of my grandma, so this made me want to do something about it, you know, help those people.
And for those that desire to help others and to serve others, it's just my passion to help them do that.
We learn everything about being in the medical health field, communication, diseases, infections, all medical terminology in general.
We are definitely doing hands-on. I love taking blood pressure, so it's really cool, a little pump. We'll be doing CPR. It's so much fun.
The students are getting their foundational health occupation classes, so at the end of their junior year, they can decide to go into the vocational aspect. And at our school, it'll be certified nurse's aide, where they continue on to the VOTEC Center to do dual enrollment for any of the other health science programs that are available to them. So our goal is to have them first get certified in certified nurse's aide, then home health aide. The kids can also do personal fitness trainers here at the high school level.
I see people that are right now in college and they haven't even started this class.
Some students, they'll come in, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a nurse, without understanding that they're over 300 careers in the health field. And then to be realistic about themselves, do you want to work with the blood and guts, or do you just want to work with papers? And realize you can do one or the other and still be an integral part of the medical team.
Now it's up to us to figure out what type of substance he actually took.
Guest speakers bring in that real world application. And I think that brings the connection piece to it. Someone says, wow, I really thought about being a pharmacist, but I'm not sure now. But after talking to the RN, I may want to be an RN now.
It helped me a lot to see, you know, what is out there in the real world, what I will be doing in the future.
The program that we're doing here today is our Regional Nursing Pathways Initiative. And it's a grant that's sponsored through the Department of Labor, hopefully inspiring them to want to become nurses, get into the nursing field. It's also something that is highly respected and well paid. And in times like these, when you don't have a guarantee of a job out of high school or college, it means a lot. So we go over vital signs, we have them test different stimulants and depressants with brine shrimp, talking about their psychological and physiological response. And then we get to bring Simman, which is our high-tech simulation dummy. He breathes, he has a heartbeat, a pulse. He can be sick, he can be well. When he talks, that's always really fun. All of which we can do through simulated scenarios to really give the students a chance to see what medical professionals are dealing with, because he's the latest and greatest from Florida Hospital. The whole time we sort of build the anticipation with this set of videos we have where they're learning about the history of the patient up until the party where he has his fatal accident, which lands him in our code blue scenario.
The kids were just really elated to see it. Yeah, learning about blood pressure was a little challenging, but to see it on the sim, man, that put the pieces together.
Well, they actually had me help with it. It was cool. Definitely a realistic example of what we're gonna have to go through.
And it was really cool because it felt real, as if I were really a doctor. So I like that experience.
Our motto is inspire science, learning for life. Our job is to have the extra mile, have hands-on things, have the simulators, things that schools might not be able to afford.
The partnership is vital to our program because it's an extension to learning for our students.
I'm going to order a secondary panel to determine the type of recreation.
I'm already understanding the medical language, knowing different parts of the body. I know almost all of the bones, the muscles, and how they work, and the diseases.
I get to take a step forward in my career. Out of high school, I could become a certified nurse assistant. I can choose either by VOTEC or Valencia. I recommend it.
They can come out of high school and go right into a job. I mean, that's phenomenal for students that need to work right away. So it's a good way to start and have their foot in the door and be working in the field while they're still in school if they want to move forward to their associate's, bachelor's, you know, or master's degree.
If you have like any idea that you want to try and attempt it, just go for it, you know, give it a try.
It's a lot of fun and it allows you to see if it's really what you want to do.